Hello students, today I am going to discuss chapter number 6, Financial Accounting and Reporting. So let's begin. Business and trading organization prepare trading account to ascertain gross profit and gross loss and net and profit and loss account to ascertain net profit and net loss for the accounting year. These organizations prepare a balance sheet at the end of the accounting year to ascertain the financial position of the business. Means a company has to follow the balance sheet for the accounting year so as to see the financial position of the company. Now, the some of the non-trading organizations are like clubs, schools, colleges, trusts, hospitals, chambers of commerce. These organizations, they need their cash position, incomes and expenses, and also the financial position. So for that, they prepare the financial statements every year. So their receipts and payments account, income and expenditure account, and lastly that is balance sheet. So here is distinction between trading and non-trading concern given over there. The basis of distinctions are activities. So trading concern, they buy and sell goods and services, but non-trading concerns, they do not buy and sell goods and services. So next is purpose. Trading concern, they aim at earning profits. Non-trading concern, they do not aim at earning profits. The types, trading concern are like wholesale and retail enterprises, and non-trading concerns are religions, charitable and educational. So examples are trading concern, bookstall, cloth store, chemist shop, and non-trading organizations are like club, school, colleges and temples. So now we'll talk about receipts and payment account. So what are they? Receipts and payment account is a summary of cash transactions. It is prepared by a non-trading organization at the end of every accounting year. Opening a balance of the cash in hand, cash at bank, and all the cash receipts are shown in on the debit side, and all the cash payments are recorded on the credit side. So what happens after that? The excess of the debit side total over the credit side total represents cash balance at the end of the accounting year. All cash receipts and cash payments are recorded irrespective of whether they belong to the current year, previous year or future year. So if you see your book, you can see a specimen of receipts and payment account given in your book. So next we will talk about the nature. The main features of receipts and payments accounts are like, the account is a summary of the cash book combining cash and the bank transactions. So basically they deal with the cash book, which deals with cash as well as the bank transactions. Next is, the account begins with the opening balance of cash in hand and at bank. So next is cash in hand written on the debit side because it always shows the debit balance. Cash at bank, that is the debit balance, is written on the debit side, but the overdraft extra balance, that is written on the credit side. Third is, it is a real account. Therefore, the rule of the real account is debit what comes in and credit what goes out is followed while preparing the account. Next is, all the cash receipts, both revenue, capital, nature, are shown on the debit side. Next, similarly, all the payments of whatever nature and for whatever period are entered are on the credit or payment side. The account is closed at the end of the year with the closing balance of cash in hand and at bank shown on the credit side. Next is, the primary objective of preparing this account is to find out the cash position and to show the receipts and payments and the different heads for the accounting year. Last is, these receipts and payments account does not reveal the surplus or the extra amount for the year because it records all the receipts payments irrespective of their nature. Now we'll talk about the uses. What are the main uses of receipts and payments account? They are, receipts and payment account serves as the basis for preparing the income and expenditure and the balance sheet. Next is, it alerts the management of a non-trading organizations. So what are the non-trading organizations like club, institutions, ओके, दीज आर द नॉन ट्रेडिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस विच आर अबाउट टू डिक्लाइन देयर कैश रिसीट्स एंड इंक्रीज इन कैश पेमेंट्स. नेक्स्ट इज इट इन्फॉर्म्स द मेंबर्स अबाउट मेन सोर्सेज ऑफ इनकम एंड मेजर आइटम्स ऑफ पेमेंट्स ऑफ देयर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. नेक्स्ट इट इज लीगली रिक्वायर्ड अंडर द कोऑपरेटिव सर्विसेज एक्ट और अदर लॉज. इफ देयर इज अ यूजेज देयर इज ऑलवेज अ लिमिटेशंस ऑल्सो. सो वट इज द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ रिसीट्स एंड पेमेंट अकाउंट? दैट दे आर रिसीट्स एंड पेमेंट अकाउंट डज नॉट रिवील सरप्लस और डेफिसिट फॉर द ईयर. It does not indicate financial position of the organization because that does not contain anything which shows that financial position of the organization. Lastly, it does not disclose details of the receipts and payments account. It just shown where the expenses are made. The detailing is not given in it. Next, just go through the distinction between receipts and payments account and cash book. Just mark it down. Follow all the points. Just learn it. Now we will talk about income and expenditure account. So what is the meaning of income and expenditure account? Income and expenditure account is prepared by a non-trading organization to ascertain the surplus or the deficit for an accounting year. It is equivalent to the profit and loss account of a business concern. So in income and expenditure account, incomes are shown on the credit side and expenses are shown on the debit side. So on the other hand, if the total of the debit side is greater than the total of the credit side, it is known as deficit. But if the total of the credit side is greater than the total of the debit side, it is called the surplus or the excess of income over expenditure. So surplus or deficit is transferred after that to the capital fund in the balance sheet. So now we'll talk about the nature. So the main features of income and expenditure account are follows. They are like, it is a nominal account. It is nominal in nature. Therefore, expenses and losses are debited and incomes and gains are credited. Next is the opening and closing balances of cash in hand and cash at bank are not recorded in it. Third, while preparing income and expenditure account, only items of revenue nature are recorded and all items of capital are not included. Next is income and expenses pertaining to only current year are recorded. All the items of income and expenditure which pertain the previous year and future are not recorded in it. It only deals with the current year. It does not deal with the previous year or the future years. Next is income and expenditure account is prepared in the same manner in which the profit and loss account is prepared. Lastly, the closing balance of this account shows surplus or deficit for the particular year. If the credit side exceeds the debit side, then it is surplus. On the other hand, if the debit side exceeds the credit side, then it is deficit. The surplus is then added to the capital fund while the deficit is deducted from the capital fund. Now we'll talk about the uses. What are the main uses of the income and expenditure account? They are like, income and expenditure account shows the surplus or deficit arising from the activities of a non-trading concern during the year. It always shows all the items of income and expenditure. So it also serves as the basis of preparing the balance sheet of a non-trading organization. Last is, it fulfills the statutory requirement because non-trading organizations are legally required to prepare it. Now, next, it is given a distinction between receipts and payment account and income and expenditure account. So, some of the points are given over there. Just mark all the points. And next is distinction between income and expenditure account and profit and loss account is also given. Just go through all the points. I'm just discussing it one by one. Nature of receipts and payment account and income and expenditure account is, इट इज़ अ समरी ऑफ कैश रिसीप्ट एंड कैश पेमेंट्स, बट इन इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट इट इज़ लाइक द प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट ऑफ अ ट्रेडिंग कंसर्न. नेक्स्ट इज टाइप ऑफ अकाउंट. रिसीप्ट एंड पेमेंट अकाउंट इज अ रियल अकाउंट एंड इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट इज अ नॉमिनल अकाउंट. नेक्स्ट ऑब्जेक्ट. इट इज़ प्रिपेयर टू नो कैश बैलेंस एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर एंड इन अदर ऑन द अदर हैंड इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट इज प्रिपेयर टू असर्टेन द सरप्लस एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर. नेक्स्ट इज नेचर. रिसीप्ट्स एंड पेमेंट्स अकाउंट कंटेन्स बोथ कैपिटल एंड रेवेन्यू आइटम्स, वेर एज इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट कंटेन्स ओनली द रेवेन्यू आइटम्स. नेक्स्ट इज ओपनिंग बैलेंस. रिसीप्ट्स एंड पेमेंट अकाउंट स्टार्ट्स विद द ओपनिंग बैलेंस ऑफ कैश इन हैंड एंड एट बैंक, बट द इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट हैज़ नो ओपनिंग बैलेंस. नेक्स्ट इज क्लोजिंग बैलेंस. इट स्टार्ट्स विद द एट द एंड शोज द कैश इन हैंड एंड एट बैंक एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर, वेर एज इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट्स बैलेंस इज एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर शोज सरप्लस और डेफिसिट फॉर द ईयर. नेक्स्ट इज एक्रूड और आउटस्टैंडिंग आइटम्स. Receipts and payment account contains only cash items and does not include accrued income, income received in advance, outstanding or prepaid expenses. But in case of income and expenditure account, it is prepared on the accrual basis and therefore includes all the accrued and outstanding items. Next is sides. Receipts and payment account. Receipts are shown on the debit side and payments are shown on the credit side, while in case of income and expenditure account, expenditure is shown in debit side and income is shown in credit side. Now the period of the items. The distinction of receipts and payment account, it includes the receipts and payments relating to the previous and next years, but in case of income and expenditure account, it includes income and expenses relating to only to the current year. Now the non-cash items. In receipts and payments accounts, it contains only cash item, but in case of income and expenditure account, it contains non-cash items like depreciation, loss on the sale of asset also. Last is balance sheet. The receipts and payment account does not need to be accompanied by a balance sheet, but in case of income and expenditure account, it must be accompanied by a balance sheet. Now I'm coming to the next part of the distinction, that is income and expenditure account whereas profit and loss account. So income and expenditure account object is, the main object of the income is, expenditure account is to ascertain surplus or deficit, but in case of profit and loss account, the main object of profit and loss account is to calculate the net profit or net loss. The nature of the organization is, in income and expenditure account, this account is prepared by non-trading organizations which do not seek to earn profit. But in case of profit and loss account, this account is prepared by trading organizations which seek to earn profit. In case of the method or the basis of preparations, income and expenditure account is prepared on the basis of receipts and payments account and other information. But in case of profit and loss account, this account is prepared on the basis of the trial balance. Next is the balance. The balance of this account shows the surplus or deficit, but in case of profit and loss account, the balance of this account shows net profit or net loss. Contents. The income and expenditure account contains items like subscriptions and donations, but in case of profit and loss account, this account does not contain such items. Next, if you turn to next page, you can see the specimen given of income and expenditure account. You can easily follow it. You can easily get to know about income and expenditure account. Next, we will talk about balance sheet. So what does the word balance sheet means? Balance sheet means it is a statement which shows the assets and liabilities of an organization and its capital on a particular date. It depicts the financial position of the organization on a specific date. It is prepared every year because to see the financial position of the company. It is the last step of the accounting year. The balance sheet is then continued to the next year. It is prepared every year. Nature. The main features of the balance sheet is, like, a balance sheet is always prepared on a particular date. It is prepared after the preparation of income and एक्सपेंडिचर अकाउंट एंड इट इज़ नॉट एन अकाउंट बट इट इज़ अ स्टेटमेंट. नेक्स्ट इज इट शोज द फिनेंशियल पोजिशन ऑन अ स्पेसिफिक डेट स्पेसिफाइड डेट. लास्ट इज एसेट्स आर शोन ऑन द राइट साइड एंड लाइबिलिटीज आर शोन ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड. नाउ वी कम टू द यूजेस ऑफ अ बैलेंस शीट. द मेन यूजेस ऑफ अ बैलेंस शीट फॉर अ नॉन ट्रेडिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आर लाइक बैलेंस शीट शोज द एसेट ओन्ड बाई अ नॉन ट्रेडिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. नेक्स्ट इज इट रिवील्स द लाइबिलिटीज ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. थर्ड इट डिपिक्ट्स द कैपिटल फंड ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. नेक्स्ट इज इट शोज द फिनेंशियल पोजिशन ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. नेक्स्ट इट फुलफिल्स द स्टैट्यूटरी रिक्वायरमेंट्स एज अ नॉन ट्रेडिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज लीगली रिक्वायर्ड टू प्रिपेयर द बैलेंस शीट. इफ यू फॉलो द स्पेसिमेन इज ऑल्सो गिवन ऑफ अ बैलेंस शीट यू कैन इजिली फॉलो इट. नेक्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एसेट्स एंड liabilities. So what are like assets? Assets are basically referred to the valuable resources that are owned by a business firm. These resources provided benefits in future periods. So some of the categories of assets are given over there. They are like fixed asset, current asset, wasting assets, fictitious assets. So let's discuss one by one. So what is fixed asset? These assets are purchased for the use in business and to generate revenue for not for the resale. So examples like land and buildings, plant and machinery, furniture, these are the examples of fixed assets. Next is current asset. These assets are converted into cash within a short period, generally like 1 year. Like current assets are of two types, liquid and floating. So liquid assets include cash in hand, cash at bank, bills receivable and short-term investment. Next is floating assets. Floating assets comprise stock in trade, sundry debtors, etc. Next is wasting assets. What is this? The value of these assets diminishes with the passage of time. Leasehold rights, mines, copyrights are the examples of wasting assets. Last is fictitious assets. So what is fictitious asset? These assets are not really asset, but the expenses of a heavy nature which are expected to provide benefits over several years. These expenses are shown as assets in balance sheet until these are written off. Share issue expenses, research and development expenses are the examples. Next, we are going to discuss about the liabilities. What is it? Liabilities are debts owned by the firm and payable in future. Liabilities are of the following types. They are fixed liabilities, current liabilities and contingent liabilities. So first we'll talk about the fixed liabilities. These are payable in the long run on the determination of business, share capital, debentures and the long-term loans are some of the examples. Next is current liabilities. These are repayable in near future, generally 1 year. Sundry creditors, bills payable, these short-term loans are the examples. Last is contingent liabilities. These liabilities become payable on the happening of a particular events. So if the events do not happen, these are not payable. So for example, guarantee given by the firm on behalf of the borrower from a bank will become payable when the borrower makes the default in payment. So lastly, there is a distinction of the fixed asset and current asset is given over there here. Please tick it so that you can read it later. So let's discuss it. Fixed asset and current asset, basis of distinctions. What is its purpose? So the purpose of fixed assets are acquired for producing good and services, and whereas the current assets are acquired for resale or conversion into cash. Next is the time period. These assets are used over a long period of time, whereas the current asset, these assets are generally used within a year. Depreciation, the fixed assets is generally charged on these assets every year, whereas the current asset, no depreciation is charged on these assets. Next is example. Plant and machinery, land and building, furniture and fixture. These are the examples of fixed assets. Next is current assets, cash in hand and cash at bank, debtors and stock are the examples of current assets. So students, I hope you have understood this chapter. Further, if you have any doubt, you can ask me through WhatsApp. Thank you.